we had a very consultative process with all the 10 value chains, all the major value chains, 10 major value chains in agriculture or agro and processing, etc. So the outcome of this is a process of various value chains, and those are also available for you at any stage. So this is just the roll-up and the top side of this that I'm indicating to you. Okay, so if we look at some of the just the main figures in terms of primary agriculture, we'll see that primary agriculture growth, that's just the farming sector, is roughly 2.5% of total GDP. But if you then look at your total contribution of the value chain, right, in other words, to the consumer, it's roughly 14% of GDP. And that then includes the contributions of agro-processing, of logistics, finance, trade, etc., other sectors of the economy. So it's sizable, very significant. If we then look at the number of jobs in primary agriculture, we don't have all these figures for all the other parts of the value chain, but we lost a lot of jobs with the financial crisis in 2009. Now we've regained all those, but you will also see the volatility of the past few years, and that is primarily because of the droughts that we've had, especially in the Western Cape, which is a big employer of labor. Then if we look at exports, then this is very important. Approximately 33%, a third of all the revenue that is earned by the primary agricultural sector, or the agricultural exports, is roughly 33% of total revenue. So we have significant player in the export market. And if we then look at the agricultural trade balance, just look at the green line, you'll see that our agricultural trade balance is positive and growing since 2006. So much so also that our exports last year exceeded $10 billion. That graph is in dollars, not in rand, so the depreciation of the rand is not factored into that. So you can see a strong growth in exports of agricultural products in dollar terms. So these are the positive news stories that we are contributing to the economy. But our primary agriculture is only growing at roughly 1.6% per annum. It's very variable, but that is so, and it's too low. So if we then look at what are the major trends in agriculture, then it's the profitability and competitiveness of the sector is under pressure, loss of agricultural land to mining and urbanization, changes in logistics, degradation of infrastructure, deteriorating regulatory, veterinary and extension services by government, reduced government investment in research and development, disease control and plant and animal health, and the foot and mouth disease outbreak comes to mind. It will cost this country between 10 and 15 billion rand, and just the loss to the fiscus will be between 3 and 4 billion rand alone in tax. And then entrenched dualism in the sector. And this is very important because the plan that we have devised is a plan for inclusive growth and development. And all the targets we are setting are aimed directly at that, also with a development agency that we propose in the plan. So if we then look at the key success factors, is the development of local processing capacity and subsequent increased production capacity. Then also global market development, incredibly important because of the export dimension, adoption of conservation agriculture and other critical sustainable agricultural initiatives. We've got to produce more with less, drive efficiency in other words. Then we also got to look at new technologies to maintain our competitiveness, world-class institutional structure and capacity. We must leverage of that common vision towards food security and food safety. So we have a sector vision to achieve a sustainable and globally competitive agricultural sector that significantly contributes to inclusive growth and ensures food security for the country through the efficient use of available resources by all participants while providing safe and nutritious food to consumers. So if we look at the sector strategy and plan, the key focus areas are expansion of markets, both globally and locally. Also training and skills development, feasible financing opportunities for new farmers, and this is where we're looking at that blended finance models with government already. Climate change, adaptation and disaster management, it's starting to hit us harder, climate change already in agriculture. Pest and disease management, including food safety considerations. These were all drafted before the foot and mouth disease outbreak. Right, then if we look at sector strategy, we went and put numbers and targets up to 2024 around investment, employment, trade balance, global food security index, transformation, etc., so that we can go and measure and implement and reach those targets together with government. Then if we look at the sector strategy and plan, obviously our objective is to attract investment and to get job creation growing in the process as well. So what are the required policy changes? I think this is very important. We need public-private partnerships and meaningful public-private partnerships, exactly as the president of Bruce stated in his opening remarks, so that we can assist us with supply chain management to ensure our competitiveness of our value chains. We need adoption and support of new technology and R&D. Financing initiatives for new entrant farmers around blended finance models, etc. Maintenance and extension of private property rights, and this is where the issue of expropriation without compensation and land reform, the disaster with land reform, come in. We need a better framework around property rights and the extension of property rights to previously disadvantaged peoples. Turnaround strategy and implementation of infrastructure plan, especially also the harbours, and Durban Harbour comes to mind. A number of sectors have raised this. We really need to sit around Durban Harbour and devise plans how to optimise that. Then also we need to look at the inhibitors to success, lack of relevant and feasible trade policies to meet new global and local consumer demands. The whole world trade space is changing around the trade wars, and we need to adapt quick and fast. Declining investment and capability in R&D, lack of coordinated and targeted infrastructure investment, uncoordinated government programs and support systems. And in agriculture, we work with numerous departments, and that coordination is a major inhibitor. Lack of targeted incentives to increase productivity and transformation in the sector, lack of capacity and skills in the sector, and illegal imports, international subsidies, crime and security, which are also major factors. Then, I'm just a few seconds away, we have government support required. I'm not going to go into those, but most of these are already in place. Programs that we've developed around soft loans, blended finance, crop insurance, etc. And it's a lot of these also around the transformation aspect. So to close, Chair, industry is fully committed to the successful implementation of the five-year sector plan to benefit agriculture and the South African economy and nation as a whole through an inclusive monitoring and evaluation public-private partnership with government. We need stronger partnerships with government to roll this out. We'll be right back.